Sermon Illustrations. A certain duke once boarded a galley ship. As he passed the crew of slaves, he asked several of them what their offenses were. Almost every man claimed he was innocent. They laid the blame on someone else or accused the judge of yielding to bribery. One young fellow, however, spoke out, "Sir, I deserve to be here. I stole some money. No one is at fault but myself. I'm guilty." Hearing this, the duke seized him by the shoulder and shouted, "You scoundrel, you! What are you doing here with all these honest men? Get out of their company at once!" He was then set at liberty, while the rest were left to tug at the oars. The key to this prisoner's freedom was the admission of his guilt. Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, author of the Sherlock Holmes mysteries, used to tell how he sent a telegram to each of 12 friends, all men of great virtue and reputation. The message read simply, "Fly at once, all is discovered." Within 24 hours, the story goes, all 12 had left the country. Bitterness. The longer you allow the root of bitterness to grow in the soil of your heart, the more love it will devour. Every bitter person had his or her start through being offended by someone. We cannot live with bitterness because it will first manifest itself in our spirit, then in our emotions, and finally in our bodies. Tom Drought. Bitterness is the offspring of an unhealed wound whose parents are unforgiveness and time. We read that in a court presided over by Judge Ivan Lee Holt, Jr., a 27-year-old woman drew a 3-year prison sentence for a fatal shooting which followed an argument over ownership of a nickel. No matter how long you nurse a grudge, it won't get better. Think about the oyster. It takes a grain of sand and turns it into a beautiful pearl. Too often, we are just the opposite. We take pearls and turn them into grains of sand. One New Year's Eve at London's Garrick Club, British dramatist Frederick Longsdale was asked by Seymour Hicks to reconcile with a fellow member. The two had quarreled in the past and never restored their friendship. "You must," Hicks said to Longsdale. "It is very unkind to be unfriendly at such a time. Go over now and wish him a happy new year." So Longsdale crossed the room and spoke to his enemy. "I wish you a happy new year," he said. But only one. Conscience versus conscience. A mother asked her son if he knew the difference between conscience and conscience. He said, "Sure, Mom. Conscience is when you're aware of something. Conscience is when you wish you weren't." Art Linkletter says, "Things turn out the best for the people who make the best of the way things turn out." What parents think children worry about? First, nuclear war. Second, terrorism. Third, being kidnapped. Four, possible divorce of parents. What children actually worry about? Grades at school. Having friends. Being teased or bullied. And being embarrassed. And here we have marriage advice. Some advice about marriage in the form of 5 don'ts. For some people can remember a negative more easily than a positive assertion. First, to the young man. Don't marry a woman who does not pray. Don't marry a bad-tempered or jealous woman. Don't marry a woman who loves the moving pictures and the matinee more than the home. Don't marry a woman who drinks. It is bad enough when a woman marries a man who drinks. Infinitely worse when a man marries a woman who drinks. Unless you have plenty of money, or she has plenty of money, so that you can employ someone to do it for you, don't marry a woman who cannot cook or cannot learn to cook. To the young woman, don't marry an unbeliever. Don't marry a man of bad habits. Don't marry a coffin man, that is, a man with room for himself and no one else. Don't marry a peacock man, a conceited man. Don't marry a man of low moral standards. From More Illustrations. And those are our thoughts for the day.